الميكروفون.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على
ومن سيئات أعمالنا، نحمده على هداية الدين الإسلام، نحمده على أن من علينا لهذا الشهر الكريم المبارك شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. ثم الصلاة والسلام على محمد ابن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. إخوة الإيمان، فنحن وإياكم في أواخر من شهر رمضان المبارك، و هذه الليالي هي من أفضل الليالي، ولنا سنة متبعة في حياة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم، حيث كان إذا كان عشر الأواخر شد ميزار وأيقظ أهله وسهر الليالي. وفي هذه الليالي توجد أو نلتمس فيها ليلة مباركة، قد نص الله سبحانه وتعالى عن هذه الليلة وسماها ليلة القدر. قال تعالى: إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما
أدراك ما ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, we say many thanks and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always for bringing us into Al-Islam. We send prayers of peace and blessings upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and upon all those who followed him and those who are following him now and those who will follow him to the day of Qiyamah. We say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala manna alayna bil Islam, has blessed us with Islam, has favored us with Islam. And we thank him, nahmaduhu, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ala ni'matil Islam, because of the favors of Islam, because of the blessings of Islam. Wa ala hulul shahr Ramadan al-Mubarak. And for us witnessing this blessed month of Ramadan. We say, Al-An Baqiya, so now it remains 10 nights. It's called Ash Awakhir, the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Walana Sunnah, and we have in the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam a sunnah, a practice. Not only did he say it, وَلَيْسَ مَا قَالَهُ فَحَسْبُ, he didn't just say it, وَلَكِنْ فَعَلْ وَطَبَّقْ, he practiced and implemented it. So one of the things that he used to do in this night, we'll explain. But what is the importance of this last 10 nights? Or the last 10 days of Ramadan? First, they are the most important nights. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made mention of this in Surah Al-Layl, in Surah Al-Fajr. And in these last 10 nights, yujad layla, there's one single night, one single night. Mubarakah, it's a blessed night. In this single night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named this night Laylatul Qadr, the night of power. Then, nazzala Qur'anan yuqra. He sent a chapter of the Qur'an that we're going to read from the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to our time, to Yawm al-Qiyamah. This surah is in the Qur'an, Surah Al-Qadr. So Allah speaks about Ramadan, then he specified this particular night. So he spoke generally about Ramadan in Surah Al-Baqarah. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyam. Now as we start the Ramadan, like the analyst will say, the funnel system, there's a broad topic. But As we go down into Ramadan, as we fast Ramadan, we start going down, the days are becoming smaller. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us the funnel system. So now he's speaking specifically about Laylatul Qadr. Because the days are going and the funnel is getting smaller. So he says in the Quran, he says, "Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr." Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. Allah says he has sent what? The Quran. In the night of power. The constitution of Muslims. The book that has stood the test of times. The book that critics and other people are trying to find fault with every single time. They read it over and over just to find out mistakes and contradictions. But this book is not from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This surah testifies that Allah says, "Inna he, Allah, anzalnahu, has sent the Quran down fi laylatil qadr, in the night of power." And now Allah is questioning, is asking, who will make us know what the night of power is? So he needs our attention, he's seeking our attention. Because the message that he's going to bring has to go home, has to go into our brains. So he says, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. What will make you understand what Laylatul Qadr is? And then he says, see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is posing the question and he's teaching us as well. Laylatul Qadri, the night of power, khayrun min alf shahr, is better than 1,000 months. A prayer in Laylatul Qadr, if it's accepted from you, is better than the prayer in 1,000 months. The sadaqah, the charity that you do in Laylatul Qadr, is better than the charity in 1,000 months. The iftar that you do in Laylatul Qadr, the person that you feed in Laylatul Qadr, the masjid that you build. So all the amal and ibadat that you do in that single night, khayrun min alf shahr. One single night. It's not only equal to 1,000 months, it's better than 1,000 months. This happens kullu sana. Every year Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings Laylatul Qadr for us. Laylatul Qadr, 1,000 months. It's approximately 83 years, 83.3. So if we round it up to be 83 years, that's a lot of hours, a lot of seconds. In the context of this 2017, if we calculate the Laylatul Qadr, the night, we find out that it is less than how many hours? We breakfast at 9:20. And before 3:40 our fasting starts. So let's say 9:30. 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, 2:30. So you'll go 5 hours. The worship, the prayer that you do in those 5 hours are better than 1,000 months. But we have myths, we have things that have been said, have been going on, we need to explain it. Firstly, there's many riwayat. هناك روايات كثيرة تدل على أنها that shows that Laylatul Qadr is in the odd number nights. 21 nights, 23, 25, 27, 29. And there are many riwayat as well, like a riwayat akthar, tazkur 25, that says, Laylatul Qadr al-tamisuha fi 27, say, seek it in the 27th night. So back home and here we used to always looking for the odd number nights. But there is also a hadith that says the Laylatul Qadr is not static. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala moves it. So why is Laylatul Qadr can be sought in the odd number nights? And especially the 27th night, it can also be sought in the even number nights. Because it is one single night. Nobody knows. لا يعلم أحد إلا الله. Only Allah knows. Because if we know that this is Laylatul Qadr, some people will not even fast. On other days, they will wait for Laylatul Qadr. They will not give charity, they will not give zakat. They will wait for Laylatul Qadr. But nobody knows. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yuridu an najtahid, He wants us to strive. Wa an natanafas, He wants us to compete. So if it's 5 hours in UK time now, that's better than 1,000 months. And those 5 hours we can seek in 9 odd nights, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened the door for us. So what did Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do? In the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha, قالت إذا كانت عشر أواخر, when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was alive, the last 10 nights when they come in, He would tighten up his apron. He would tighten up, if you like, his belt. He wasn't using belt that day. So he would tighten up. And then, وَسَهَرَ الْلَيَالِ, and then he would spend the whole night in vigil, up. He wouldn't be sleeping. And then, وَأَيْقَزَ أَهْلَهُ, he would wake his family. Those who can pray, to wake them up. So firstly, he would be more determined. And he himself would pray the whole night. And then he would wake up his family to join him in prayers. Now all this has Quran to support it. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us. He says, "Qoo anfusakum wa ahlikum nar." Say, stop yourself, prevent yourself and your families from going to Jahannam. So when you stand up to pray, you have to tell your family to pray. So there should be unity of purpose. There should be unity in the house. That's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us, when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us to marry, He said, marry the woman that have deen. Because you have unity of purpose, so there's unity, there's tranquility, there's peace in the house. So when you speak the language of Salah, when you speak the language of Laylatul Qadr, it doesn't become a nuisance. Somebody there understands. So this is what the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do. And then he used to do itikaf. Itikaf is when he leaves all yatru kullu umuru dunya, everything that concerns the dunya. When takalil al masjid, then he comes to the masjid. Biniyat al luzum, with the intention of staying in the masjid. اللزوم في المساجد في المسجد بالطاعات والعبادات. Staying in the masjid doing worship, doing act of worship. It is necessary, if it's extremely necessary, that you will go out quickly, do something and come back. But this is a sunnah. So I type him in Adam and Kamal Adam and Allah, come up and stop for a bakum in our kind of. Alhamdulillah, I say many thanks and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the first khutbah, we mentioned about Laylatul Qadr, and we're going to continue with that. Before we end the khutbah, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nazzala Qur'an and yuqra. He sent a Qur'an that's going to be read ila qiyam sa'ah. And he named this night, night of power. And what is the night of power? He says, it's better than 1,000 months. And in that night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes very important decisions. Yufraqu kullu amrin hakim. So he makes important decisions on the night of power. Scholars are saying death, life, wealth, poverty, illness, all things connected to mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make those decisions. Then he said, in that very night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors us with Nuzul Jibreel. And Jibreel comes down with the other angels. Nazzal al Malaika, the angels will come down. Wa ruh, and the chief of them. And there will be peace until Fajr. Most of us, our lifespan is not going to be over 50, over 60, over 70. People who are 80 years old now, they're getting fewer and fewer. But my brothers and my sisters in the deen, when you meet up, when you are able to get one Laylatul Qadr in your life, one Laylatul Qadr wahida fakat, if it's accepted from you, is a qubila min, then you have got 83 years. So these are the last 10 days. Walumuru bi khawatim. These are the last 10 days, and these are the final days and nights of Ramadan 2017. So, ashaqi, the one who is unfortunate, yatakasa, we relax now. Oh, we fast 20 days. Okay, like people used to say back home, oh, they left for their father now. So we're leaving it to those good Muslims. So they are counting themselves as not good Muslims. So they themselves are telling themselves that they are not good enough. And they are telling themselves that they don't want Allah's mercy. So they live in the Ramadan. Yes. And this is the night, this is the time when you have Laylatul Qadr. like 50 meters of your race. So what do you do if you run in a race and you've seen the end line? Do you slow down? You double up. Because this akhi, this ukhti may be your last Ramadan. You never know. Nobody has guaranteed that next Ramadan will be here. Nobody has guaranteed that by the end of this Ramadan will be here. So do this last 10 days with vigor. Kullu juhudin. And determination. Now the masjid is getting empty. Okay. If this is your last Ramadan, what are you going to tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You don't have guarantee. If this is your last Juma, what are you going to tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Like the brother who died in Peckham. He went to pray Juma. It was his last Juma. So you don't have a guarantee, akhi. Come to the masjid today and give donation for Allah. Give iftar. Walk as if you will not live to see tomorrow. Every time you have the opportunity to live, think if it's going to be my last day. So do it bi kulli ikhlas, with all sincerity. And those who are happy, as Saeed, those who are fortunate, they are the people who will double up their effort. They are the people who pray more. Because Qiyamul Layl is going to start. Taraweeh is going to start. Taraweeh is already started. And they are the people who get leather in ibadah. They get good taste. They got good appetite. They got good flavor when they're praying, when they're doing ibadat. And we know that one of the dua that the Rasulullah made when he said Ameen, when Jibreel said, it's sad and it's unfortunate for somebody who sees Ramadan, witness Ramadan, and they cannot benefit. Ramadan finishes and their sins have not been forgiven. And the Rasul said Ameen. So would you want to be in that category? So therefore, please my brothers, please my sisters, these are the last minutes, last days, last nights. It's not going to be long. Next Friday, inshallah, will be the last Friday of Ramadan. And then 1 or 2 days after that, we're going to be doing our Eid, inshallah. So what are you waiting for? So do iftar, do more, pray more. If your job does not allow you to be praying there, then take holiday. If you can pray at your job, fine. Pray. Don't waste time on social media. Because this is not going to benefit you, akhi. Stay focused on what will be beneficial for you, Yom Al-Qiyamah. Those whom will bury, that's it. If they haven't done Sadaqah to Jaya, there's nothing that will bring them back here. And the same thing is going to happen for us. Once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes the ruh, the life, that is it. You can't come back. And every single year, every single hour that's going, it's our life that's going. But sometimes you don't realize, you think, oh, we're still here. My friend, you're not here. You're going. You're walking towards your grave all the time. But do it with sincerity. Pray more. Leave this too much talk on the phone. Read Quran more. Do more dhikr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins. And finally, the dua for people who are regular in the masjid, it's known. But Aisha radiallahu anha said, ask the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is a kind of Laylatul Qadr. If Laylatul Qadr is upon us, what do we say? What do we do? Then he taught her, and she taught us a very nice dua. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. Oh Allah, you are out forgiven. And you love to forgive. So forgive us our sins. Very simple formula. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. But we say this and we want Allah to forgive us. Have we forgiven others? It's 12 months now. Some people it's 10 years. You have severed relationship with your brother. For what? For money. For what? For dunya. For what? For ideology. For what? For difference of opinion. Difference of opinion. You see this way, the other person is seeing that way, and you stop talking to each other. It is haram for a Muslim. It is haram for a Muslim to stop talking to another Muslim for 3 days. How much more you are living with your wife at home and you don't speak to each other? How much more you are living with your brother in this country, in other places, you don't speak to them? But dunya. Akhi, this Ramadan has to clean and soften our heart. I feel very disappointed when I see Muslims have strong minds. I feel so disappointed. What's the salah for? What's the imam reading these beautiful du'as for us for? What's the imam reading these beautiful voices, reading the Quran for us all the time? What are you listening to the Quran for? What are you doing wudu for? What are you saying salam for? What are you saying Ramadan Mubarak for? Your heart is hard like stone. You cannot think that one day we're going to put you down and you're not going to be able to talk, you're not going to be able to speak, you're not going to dress yourself. You are immortal, my friend. You're going to die. Stop. Make amends. Talk to people. Tell them you're sorry. And let them forgive you as you forgive them. We are so hard-hearted. Dunya, it's all about money now. The pen is a long and full song. I love to hear the drama. I'm not going to have a house. 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 اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعفو عنا فاعفو عنا يا كريم فاعفو عنا يا رحيم فاعفو عنا يا غفار فاعف جميع ذنوبنا اللهم اغفر لجميع مات المسلمين الذين شهدوا لك بالعهد وبنبيك بالرسالة وماتوا على ذلك اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافهم واعف عنهم واقم نزلهم ووسم مدخلهم وادخلهم في السجنات والجنات. Let me sell it.